Greetings. This is the second video in a series answering a particular claim made by a Mohammedan. How can Islam be from Satan? Let me just recap what he said. Basically, you are trying to say that Prophet Muhammad was a false prophet. If Islam was not from God, it must come from Satan. But this is against the teaching of your own Bible. Satan can't talk against themselves. Let's move along to the second point. Well, what are Satan's goals? Basically, Satan has two goals. One, Satan wants to be elevated above the God of Abraham. Isaiah 14:13. And you said in your heart, I will ascend to heaven. I will exalt my throne above the stars of God. I will sit upon the Mount of Assembly in the uttermost north. Satan wants to be greater than God. Satan wants people to shout, you are greater. And point number two, Satan wants to devour and destroy human beings so that you do not spend eternity with God. 1 Peter 5:8, be well balanced, be vigilant and cautious at all times, for that enemy of yours, the devil, roams around like a roaring lion in fierce hunger, seeking someone to seize upon and devour. And what does that accomplish? Matthew 25:41, then shall he say unto them on the left hand, depart from me, you cursed, into everlasting fire, prepared for the devil and his angels. You see, hell was prepared for Satan and his angels, but he wants to take as many men with him as he may trick into following him. Satan wants your company in hell with him for eternity. Here are some other descriptions of Satan from the Word of God. 1 Chronicles 21:1. Satan stood up against Israel and stirred up David to number Israel. So Satan opposes God's people. Job 1:11. But reach out your hand and strike down everything he has. Then I'm sure he will speak evil things against you. In fact, he'll do it right in front of you. The Lord said to Satan, all right, I am handing everything he has over to you, but do not touch the man himself. Then Satan left the Lord and went on his way. Satan taunts God and accuses righteous people. Matthew 16:23. Jesus turned and said to Peter, get behind me, Satan. You are standing in my way. You do not have in mind the things of God. Instead, you are thinking about human things. Satan keeps human ungodly thinking in your mind. Mark 1:13. He was in the desert 40 days. There Satan tempted him. The wild animals didn't harm Jesus. Angels took care of him. Satan brings temptation to test you, trick you, and make you sin. Acts 5:3. Then Peter said, Ananias, why did you let Satan fill your heart? He made you lie to the Holy Spirit. You have kept some of the money you received for the land. Satan fills your heart with thoughts, so you lie. O Mohammedan, when you lie, do you not know that it is Satan who has placed the lie in your heart and on your lips? Taqiyya is just such a lie. You invite the father of lies into your heart and embrace his lie out of fear. Luke 13:16. This woman is a member of Abraham's family line, but Satan has kept her disabled for 18 long years. Shouldn't she be set free on the Sabbath day from what was keeping her disabled? Satan seeks to disable you from living life. Ultimately, Satan is just evil. John 8:44, ye are of your father the devil, and the lusts of your father you will do. He was a murderer from the beginning, and abode not in the truth, because there was no truth in him. When he speaketh a lie, he speaks of his own, for he is a liar, and the father of it. So Satan is a liar, a deceiver, in fact, the father of lies. This video is not attempting to prove who Al-Makar is, or Al-Makar. I just want you to grasp that Satan is a liar and will tell lies to trick you. And I want you to know Al-Haq tells the truth. In fact, Al-Haq is the truth. So remember, O Mohammedan, Satan is a liar and will tell lies to trick you. Have no doubt Satan may tell a truth to give his lie the smell of truth. But what exactly does that mean? Here is an example I want you to understand. The truth is there is one God, the God of Abraham. Would Satan say there is one God? Yes, he would. But if you ask him, who is the one God, Satan will say, he is. Now, wouldn't that be a lie? Yes, it would be a lie. But would it serve his purposes to tell you just such a lie? Yes, it would. If you believed his lie, even in a sincere desire to worship the one true God, you would worship him as God. And if you spoke Arabic, you would call him Allah. And even using the word Allah, meaning God, you are not worshiping the one true God. You are worshiping Satan, who told you he was the one true God. So how does this relate to our text and the question by the Mohammedan? It comes from the fact that Satan wishes to lead you away from Almighty God and from the salvation God has provided for you. And Satan will tell lies to trick you, including lies that say, "Follow me and I will lead you to submit to God." Satan will lie and say, "I am Allah." This is the hardest reality for those who cling to Islam and Muhammad. A lie that mixes some truth is the hardest to recognize. But Satan, saying he is the one true God and telling you to worship him and call him Allah, is still a lie that tricks you away from the real one true God of Abraham. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. In the next video on this topic, I want to present another example of Satan's deception in creating Islam.